Welcome to my new revamped channel, where I cover the basics of abandoned structures and failing retail centers. You are now watching my first video segment of Almost Abandoned. Please make sure you are subscribed and click the notification bell so you know when new videos are added. Once listed as the largest mall in Georgia, before being dropped down to the fourth largest mall, sits a dead shopping center in the city of Macon. 83 miles from the city of Atlanta and 115 miles from Savannah, Georgia, sits a stagnant shopping mall in a very blighted area. This retail outlet is simply known as Macon Mall. Although today, Macon Mall may be considered the old mall by locals of the area, it was once a booming town that attracted a large population of shoppers boasting over 120 stores. Macon Mall was constructed between two roads, Mercer University Drive and Eisenhower Parkway. Macon Mall opened in 1975 as the Colonial Macon Mall, with department stores like JCPenney, Sears, Davison's, and Belk Matthews. This was around the time of the golden ages of malls across the United States. This also led to the decline of Macon's first enclosed mall, Westgate, to shutter and redevelop. The first change came in 1986 when a food court was added, and the Davison's department store was renamed to Macy's in favor of the parent company, retiring the name. Before this, most department stores featured their own restaurants. The mall was rising in popularity, which prompted new stores to enter the Macon market, with the mall at full capacity. In 1997, the mall was expanded, adding two new anchors, Dillard's and Parisian's, as well as 40 new stores. New stores including Disney, Abercrombie & Fitch, Express, Hollister, and Suncoast, just to name a few, many of which being new to the Macon market. This expansion happened by incorporating JCPenney as part of the mall, in which one must walk through JCPenney to access the other half of the mall from the inside. Two new parking decks were also constructed to handle the increase of traffic, expanding the once 1.1 million square feet to 1.5 million square feet, massively increasing its size. A second level was added to the food court, adding a Sbarro, an Atlanta bread company, among others. The food court was branded as Cafe Carousel in favor of the carousel that sat upstairs in the food court. A Ruby Tuesday was also added to the mall in the lower level of the food court. Macy's was also rebranded as Riches around this time. This also earned Macon Mall a Super Regional Mall title and made it one of the largest malls in Georgia. Well, until the opening of Mall of Georgia in 1999 and the expansion of Atlanta's Perimeter Mall, demoting it to the fourth largest mall in the state by the early 2000s. This brought the store count in the mall from 75 to 120. Macon Mall was the leading shopping destination until the opening of a nearby shopping center called Eisenhower Crossing, which brought in Macon's first Target, Best Buy, Dick's Sporting Goods, and more in 2001. This only did minor damage by taking Old Navy from the mall and having it relocate there. Eisenhower Crossing was built just 1¾ miles from the mall, but sat closer to I-475, giving it direct access to the interstate. This center also duplicated stores that were already in the mall, such as Payless Shoe Source, Bath & Body Works, and GameStop. Around this time, Rich's was dual-branded to Rich Macy's, and Steven Berry's opened as a junior anchor to the mall, being located next to Sears on the upper level. In 2004, Colonial Properties, who owned the mall, put the mall up for sale as the company was restructuring to more residential development than retail. The mall was sold to Lightstone Group for $170 million, and the Colonial name was retired from the mall, giving its present name today as Macon Mall. All Colonial signage through the interior and exterior of the mall was removed or covered up. Macon Mall was determined unstoppable throughout the early 2000s until around the time the recession hit. Around this time, Rich's name was dropped and renamed Macy's in favor of the company, eliminating regional names. The first blow came when the 102-square-foot Parisian was closed in 2007. This was closed when Belk purchased the chain from Saks Incorporated and retired the Parisian name. All Parisian stores were renamed Belk, but since Macon Mall already had a larger Belk store, the Parisian was shuttered. The mall entered foreclosure in 2008 due to Lightstone defaulting on their loan, and it was put under the operation of Joan Lang LaSalle. Around this time, construction of a new lifestyle center in North Macon was completed by the name of Shops at River Crossing, managed by General Growth Properties. This center was to be anchored by Dillard's and featured tenants such as Barnes & Noble, Gap, Victoria's Secret, Motherhood Maternity, Build-A-Bear, Talbot's, Coach, Yankee, and several other specialty stores. The new shopping center was 13 miles north of Macon Mall. Dillard's left the mall in 2008 in favor of only wanting to concentrate on the store in the Macon area. Linens and Things was also closed around this time that sat on a former lot of the Macon Mall Regal Cinemas. This was due to the company declaring bankruptcy. This then left both anchor stores added in 1997 closed. By the end of 2009, many tenants began to leave the mall in favor of the Shops at River Crossing, including some stores closing through corporate bankruptcy. Some stores even left the Macon market entirely. Crime was also on the rise in West Macon after numerous fights were reported on the mall premises, most notably in the food court where tables and chairs were thrown. In the fall of 2010, the mall was acquired by Hull Story Gibson and announced plans of a renovation and demolition of the 1997 expansion wing. By this time, only American Eagle, Finish Line, Rue 21, Spencer's, USPS Branch, and Victoria's Secret remained in the wing. The new owners gave notice to the remaining tenants to relocate, in which many closed altogether due to already having another location at the newer mall. Finish Line, Rue 21, Spencer's, and a T-Mobile kiosk were the only ones to relocate to the older part of the mall. In 2011, demolition began on the former Parisian building, followed by demolition of the parking garage and the rest of the expansion added in 1997, except for the former Dillard's. The renovation also began with many of the mall relics being removed, such as the fountains, grand staircases, plants, and skylights. The carousel was also removed, and carpet was placed throughout the entire mall. Closed storefronts were also covered up with historic photos. In 2012, we saw the closure of Sears in Belk. Sears closed its 202,000 square foot location at the mall due to a decline of sales, while Belk closed its doors wanting to focus on the newer store that was opened in phase two of the River Crossing Shopping Center. Despite these closures, the owners opened two new stores, B. Turner's and Dry Falls, in the spaces formerly occupied by Old Navy and a few other tenants. A 15,000 square foot restaurant was also opened, named Smokin' Pig. In 2013, the former Dillard's building was demolished, which was the last remnants of the 1997 expansion. In 2015, it was confirmed that Burlington would occupy the upper level of Sears after relocating from the dying Westgate Shopping Center a couple miles down the road. In 2016, the center court escalators were removed to cut costs on electricity. JCPenney announced its closure on March 17, 2017, as part of closing several stores nationwide. JCPenney finally closed in late July, leaving Burlington and Macy's as the only remaining anchor stores. Earlier that month, Macy's announced plans to close two stores in Georgia, with one being Macon Mall and the other South DeKalb Mall. With Macy's leaving in the spring of 2020, I'm unsure of what's going to happen to this mall. Retailers such as Rue 21, Champs, Burlington, Shoe Department, and a handful of others will remain. The rising and growing crime in the area led to local shoppers not feeling safe while being in West Macon. Macon Mall gained a bad reputation from known incidents such as robberies, food court fights, and a strict security presence. Another reason for this mall's fate was that the mall was not accessible right off a major interstate. It sits in between Interstate 475 and 75, being 2 miles from each end. The area around the mall is not doing well, as dealerships that once surrounded the mall relocated to North Macon around the shops. Others closed as well due to corporate bankruptcies such as the Circuit City and Hi-Fi Buys across the street. And the Linens and Things we mentioned before is now home to an Office Depot. O'Charlie's and the Steak and Shake that sits on the mall's property are abandoned and deteriorating. Another reason is that many people prefer to shop online and just not wanting to go to malls anymore. In my opinion, the mall should become a mixed development center offering spaces for offices and medical use. They should lease some of its spaces to schools, such as Mercer or Central Georgia Tech, for classrooms and other workshops. This could also make use of the vacant anchor stores that are reaching nearly 10 years of unoccupancy. Maybe even adding call center jobs. Well, let me know what you think in the comments of how you feel about this once thriving mall. Also, let me know if you think the owners are the ones to blame, or the economy and crime itself.